Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jet, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to create monthly calendars in Affinity Publisher. Affinity Publisher is a professional level desktop publishing software, much like Adobe InDesign. And this program is fantastic as it gives you almost all features that InDesign has at a fraction of a cost. By the way, if you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe and hit that notification bell so you'll get notified whenever I post videos like this. And I also have tutorials on how to create calendars in InDesign and Canva as well. Links are in the description and you might want to check it out. So without further ado, let's jump into the tutorial. I hope you enjoy. So now I'm inside my Affinity Publisher. And this document is sized 8.5 by 11 inches, and that's the letter size document. And got bleed over here and my margins. It's up to you if you want to put those or not. Okay, so first things first, I want to go to stock over here. And if you don't see this one, it's in view and go to studio and it's right here. And these are all your tools. Now you can choose from any of these photo sites. There's Unsplash, Pexels and Pixabay, and then you just search for whatever photos that you want to use. And just make sure that you attribute the owner of the photo if it needs to be attributed, or some of them are actually free, so just make sure of it. So I'm just going to use this one. Just click and drag it over here. And it says this photo is by Nahil Nasir. Alright, now all I have to do is, here and just drag it over there. Let's see, and size it. Hold on, that's it, like that. That's good enough for me. Now go to the text tool and just put, for example, this B. Let's make it bigger, maybe something like this, and make it in center it, and then change the font. This and change the color of the font, something that's probably white, this way. Right, so I don't want that, like, all right, there you go. Now just resize this and center it there. If you move it, there's the center line, the green one. All right, and I'm gonna do another one. Oops, maybe 2022. Change this to Arial. Next thing we're gonna do is create the boxes for our calendars for the days. And so just go ahead and click on this rectangle over here. And if yours is not the first one, you can always find it here. So that's the rectangle. And just hold shift so you have the perfect size or dimension. There you have it. And I want the stroke for this probably like 0.3. okay, and choose this in the middle. Now I want the stroke to be white, and the fill I want it like this, transparent, something like this. There you go, I have the lines here, so maybe we can make this 0.5. there, a little bit bigger. Okay, I think that's good enough. All right, now I want put date over here, so just go ahead and use the text tool again, and then let's just put this 00 for now. You can always change that. Okay, that's good enough for now. Okay, so now next thing is click this and then click this, and you can see it here. It's, if you don't want to click it here, just click this on the layer section and then hit Command or Control G to group. So now that we have this group, all you have to do is hit Command J to copy it there, and then go to Transform. If you don't see Transform over here, just go to View and then Studio, and here's your Transform. This group is still selected. We have to make sure that we are on this X and Y values. And it says here in our width and height, we have 1.257 inches of width. And we want to populate 7 of this box over here. So what we're gonna do is just go to the x-axis and then hit plus, then the 1.27257. So 1.257, and then hit enter. So what you're gonna do again to populate this, since we need another one, and then go ahead and maybe just copy this there and hit Command J again and click this group, and let me minimize that. While holding shift, I'd like to make it smaller, something like this. All you have to do, while these are all highlighted, click on Command or Control G again to group them, and now hit Command J to copy that, because we need 6 down here. So we're going to concentrate on the Y values. So the y-axis here, all you have to do is go ahead and put that plus sign, and then our height, it says here that it's 1.071, so just copy that one and then go here on the y-axis, put plus, there you go. So it goes down that other one, and then just hit Command J. So we need 2 more, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right, so can highlight them and then Command Control G. Now we only have one group over there, so if you do this, it goes there, and I want it to be somewhere here. All right, you have perfect squares over here, so all you have to do is just change the numbers or the days over here. I'm not gonna do that right now in this tutorial, so because I want to show you everything. So copy Command C and Command V, and I'm gonna put it here. I'm gonna change this to notes. Now go to rectangles again. This one's big, right? There you have it, and then something like this. Now I'm gonna make some lines down here. So I'm gonna go ahead, click the pen tool. I'm just gonna click one here while holding the shift key, click on the last one here, so it makes a really good line. I'm gonna change this into dash line and hit that butt cap. All right, if you check, let's see, it is this one. It's not so clear, so I'm gonna make it maybe 1 point. Let me see it bigger. And then I'm holding the optional Alt key and then just drag it down. It doesn't matter if it's not aligned yet or anything, we'll do it later. So once you have it, just highlight all of them here or here, and then go here to Align Options or Properties. Now go ahead and click this space horizontally and align vertically, and then just hit Apply, and it's perfectly aligned. All right, so there you have it. You have your January, and if you want to personalize this and want to put, for example, somebody's birthday over here, so what you're going to do is hit this rectangle again, and let's zoom this. For example, this is the day, so we can just maybe put something like this, and we can change the color, maybe green. All right, now change these. All right, and I don't want the dash line over there, so I'm going to change it to line, and maybe a little bit there, 0.5. okay, but this is your preference, so maybe let's do no stroke, might be better. All right, so there you go. And you can also put some text like this, maybe Martha's, and then maybe 9 or 8. You can change that a little bit lighter. There you go. And you can change the font if you like. Now here's a cool thing too. What you're gonna do is go to this picture frame ellipse tool. You can hold shift so you can have that perfect circle, and move it down here. And you can say, for example, you have the photo of Martha or whoever. So let's say this is Martha, and we can hit there. There you have it. So you can put someone else's photo over there. So now that you have this, all you have to do is copy this one and go to pages, and then just duplicate this page. Just go ahead and click this and then hit duplicate. And now you have another one here. So just change it to, say, February. Now let's get rid of Martha here, whatever you have on this February, and then you can also change this one and go ahead and go to stock again. Let's see if I have that. Let's do this one. So I'm just gonna put this over here. Now arrange it and move it back. And there you go. So for example, if February 2022 starts on this and ends on maybe this line, and you don't want all these other boxes over here, what you can do is click on this and just delete them, and you can have just this part, or for example February starts over here or here. So just double click on this one, then delete that. So you can customize everything or anything around this. Just duplicate everything, then change the photo to whatever you like, and just change the text also, or the date, and that's it. So now you have your very own personalized calendar. All right, there you have it. I hope you guys found that useful. Click the subscribe button and that bell if you want to get notified every time I put one of these videos out. And please check out my videos on how to create calendars using InDesign and Canva. Links are in the description. Okay, keep watching and keep learning. Take care, and I'll see you next time. Bye.